Students, myself Ms. Rachna Jain, Associate Professor, Department of English, Government PG College, Rajgarh, Alwar. Today in this video lecture, I am going to explain you the poem The Sea and the Skylark, composed by G.M. Hopkins. This poem is in the syllabus of BA Part 3rd, English Literature, Paper 1st, Unit A. Today's topic of my video lectures are Introduction, again introduction to the poet G.M. Hopkins. Then the summary of the poem The Sea and the Skylark, a brief summary. And thirdly, the explanation of the important passage of the poem The Sea and the Skylark. Now, first of all, I give you a brief introduction to the poet G.M. Hopkins. G.M. Hopkins was born in Essex in England. He was the eldest son of a prosperous middle-class family. He was educated at Highgate School and Balliol College, Oxford, where he read classics and began his lifelong friendship with Robert Bridges. Then he was converted to Roman Catholicism in 1866 and entered the Jesuit order in 1868. Hopkins gave up writing poetry but resumed writing in 1875 with the shipwreck of the Deutschland. In 1877 he was ordained and was priest in a number of parishes. From 1882 to 1884 he taught at Stoneyheart College, and in 1888 he became classic professor at University College Dublin. Hopkins' poems were not published in his own lifetime. After his death, his friend Robert Bridges published them in 1918. Hopkins has been described as the greatest of Victorian poet, but on account of the date of publication and the spirit of experience dwelt in these poems, Hopkins belongs more to the 20th century. Now, I give you a brief summary of the poem The Sea and the Skylark so that you can understand the meaning in explanation. The poet hears two sounds very clearly when he was walking towards the seashore. These sounds came from opposite directions. The poet knows that both sounds very well. From the right side, the poet hears the sound of the sea tides striking against the seashore. The flood or fall of the sea waves will continue so long as the moon waxes and wanes. From his left side, the poet hears the sound of the skylark singing. Each song of the bird is fresh and lovely. The skylark sings effortlessly. Each time he sings a fresh song. The music of the sea waves and the skylark is both fresh and natural. Their music puts the townish people to the shame. The music of the town is sordid and confused. The music of nature is fresh and vitalizing. First of all, I tell you the word meaning of this poem. Year and year means 2 years. The two sounds, one of the sea and the other of the skylark, fall on the 2 years of the poet. Two noises, too old to end. It means two noises which have been heard for so long at a time that they may be regarded as everlasting, two immortal noises which will continue forever and forever. Trench means impress themselves. Right means from right hand direction comes the noise of the sea waves. The tide that runs against the shore, it means the high tides that strike against the seashore and rush towards the ramps of the protective seawall. Ramps also means rump or ram. With a flood or a fall means the seashore is flooded when the waves strike against it, but when the waves retreat, the shore is left drenched but not flooded. Low lull of or all roar. It means there is a lull or a pause after the wave strikes against the shore and then retreat. But when the next wave comes, there is all roar or a big noise. Frequenting there, the sea waves will continue to strike the shore. Veer means become smaller in size. Wind means grow bigger in size. These are the opening lines of Hopkins' sonnet entitled The Sea and the Skylark. It is one of those poems written by Hopkins in which he contrasts the beauty of nature with the ugliness of mankind's work. Explanation. These lines describe the sounds of the sea waves rising and falling. The waves come and go, they rise and fall. The tides are controlled by the moon. The poet is walking by the seaside. He hears two sounds coming from the opposite directions. These sounds are as old as the world itself. The sounds will never cease and will last till the world lasts. These two sounds make a deep impression on the poet's ears. From the right side comes the noise of the sea, which at high tide strikes against the shore and rushes towards the ramps of the protective seawall. With each wave, the water floods the seashore and then recedes, and this process continues. When the sea waves retreat, there is a lull, the noise stops for a while. But when the tide returns, the sea roars like a lion. This process of sea waves striking against the seashore and then receding, striking again and receding will continue as long as the moon continues to wane and wakes, because the tides are controlled by the moon. Now I tell you the word meaning used in this poem. Left hand. Left hand means from the left hand of the poet. Off land means above the earth or far away from the sea. Ascend. Fly to upwards into the sky. Rash fresh means sweeping hand long with a fresh song. Rewind means renewed, refreshed. New skin score. It means the song of the skylark is like a musical score which is compared to a new skin of wool. In creeps of curl and whirl, the skylark whirls his music score off the winch of his throat, not in smooth and even flow. but in a crisp curls of melody. Every note of the melody is compared to a lock of fleece waving in the air. And pour means the skylark pours his music effortlessly with ease. And pelt music means the skylark also pelts his music with great effort continuously without a pause. Till none to spill nor spend. It means till nothing is left to pour out or produce. Spill means to pour and spend means to use or produce. And pour and pelt music. The skylark pours his music and is produces his music and melody without any effort. In these lines, the poet tells us about the song of the skylark. From his left hand, some distance away from the seashore, comes the sound of the skylark singing as he leaves the earth and flies up into the sky. The skylark's song is ever the same. It seems to follow a musical score which may be compared to a skein of wool that is successively unwound as he sings in the sky and rewound when he returns to earth, so that each song is as fresh as the one before. This score the skylark seems to whirl off the winch of his throat in the wild ecstasy, and not in a smooth or even flow, but as it were in crisp curls of melody. Every note of this melody may be compared to a lock of fleece waving in the air. The skylark pours out music without effort, and yet he pelts his fresh song with continuous effort till he has split and spent all and there is nothing left. The skylark goes up so high and away that the music is heard no more. So students, today in this video lecture, I have explained you two stanzas of the poem The Sea and the Skylark. The remaining part of the poem, I will teach you in the next video. So thank you for listening to my presentation. I hope you enjoyed it. Thank you.